I started my music, my career obviously as a dancer. And then after being tired of the instructions, because I still can't take instructions very well. So at the theater, there are so many instructions. So I left to pursue music. But I paid my dues in the music industry because back in 96, I was hustling already. I had my demo, I had my fair share of demos, chasing people and stuff when I was trying to be in this music industry. And then I decided to go to school because I hate the fact that I can't finish something because somebody's not there. I think I just can't live with myself. I studied music because of that particular reason, that I wanted to read music. It broadened me like a lot because my mind and even the way I approach music, because it's not just only about talent sometimes. It's like I know I break rules sometimes, but at least it's beautiful for you to break rules when you know, okay, the rule, I know I shouldn't be playing this sharp 11 here, but it sounds nice. I'm gonna play it, you know? Fake book and the real book are music theory books. So if you're a music student, if you're studying jazz, those are books where you go to learn standard songs that were done by the greats. When you're at school, they become your music Bible. On this album, I referred a lot to fake book and the real book. I was going back to school and being like, okay, what is it that I learned? And I wanted to apply it on this album. Because I wanted to come up with an album that I'd be proud of. For me, this is not a hit album. It's not a whatever. It's just one album that I'm proud of. It's one thing that I'd be like, in the music industry, this is my contribution. I worked hard on this one. I never wanted my performance to be the same, so I decided not to have dancers because that would make me confined into the choreography. So for me to be able to be spontaneous and do whatever that it is that is coming in my mind, let me just be alone and don't rely on other people. Secondly, I needed to have band members. I needed to do away with just the backing track sequence because people do have my CDs. So it challenges me all the time when I'm on stage, even with my guys, like people that I've been working with, my band members, they know me, they know how I think. We could just sing a popular song by now or sing like an old classic now, because it's spontaneous, it's there. I sometimes look at politicians, it's way politicians think that they can influence. Musicians are like the influencers of the world, you know what I mean? Because some even their kids that they gave birth to, they sometimes don't listen to them, but they will know wasting my time from expanding from one lyric to another. But they don't know about the state of the nation address. You know, South African music is taking over, like big time, not because I'm from South Africa. I'm saying that because in South Africa, we are the only country that competes with the world. There's American music in South Africa, believe it or not. There's European music here, there's Chinese, there's a lot of music. Someone has to choose between Beyonce, Zakes Bantwini, and Rihanna, and Adele. Whereas in America, they have to choose between themselves. So when your music in South Africa plays on radio, it's gold. Because it's difficult. Like, they have a lot of catalog, these people. I think other musicians, they have it easy. Here we have it tough.